When I am explaining the truth is explained in a very clear manner. One of our brahmacharins says, Swamiji, they listen to you. It is very delightful to listen to you. And they are happy. But I don't think they understand what you say. I was amazed that he makes such a remark. It's very delightful when we listen to you. That delight is there. But whether the listeners understand the message, grasp it and gain it, I don't think they do. So this is a point that you can think about. But I seem to be thinking differently. If true satsanga is had from the satsang, ajnana hetukrita moha mahandhakara nasham, the entire delusion resulting from ignorance is destroyed and viveka arises. This is the benefit of satsang. Bhagyodayena, bhagyodayena, bahujanma samarjitena, satsangameva labhate purusho yada vai, ajnana hetukrita moha mahandhakara nasham vidhayahi tatodayate viveka. दृश्यं प्रदीदं प्रविलापयन् सन् दृश्यं प्रदीदं प्रविलापयन् सन् सन्मात्रमानन्दघनं विभावयन् सन्मात्रमानन्दघनं विभावयन् समाहितः सन् बहिरन्तरं वा कालं न येथाः सदि कर्म बंधे कालम नये था सदि कर्म बंधे आई वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस वर्स इन समवाट गुड लेंथ सी वी हैव यूनिवर्सिटीज यूनिवर्सिटीज I went into the meaning of the word university. I did not find a proper meaning in one of the best dictionaries of the world, one or two of them. I believe the word university has come from the word universe. It should be, is it not? But they only say it's a place or a center of learning. If there is a university, the university has to take the subject of the universe. Universe itself should be the subject. In the universe, what all things are there? What are the constituents of the universe? If you analyze it properly, I believe we are living on the earth, this globe. This globe is surrounded by a number of other planets and heavenly bodies. They form themselves into galaxies, groups, and so many other things. We may start from the earth, but we cannot end up with the earth. Now, so many other planets and heavenly bodies, though distant from us, some of them have got current daily operational value. What are they? Primarily the sun. The sun makes the day and night for us. Though the sun is at a great distance, we may not be able to reach it any time in our life. Nevertheless, we are in touch with the sun, sun's rays. Similarly, we have the moon. Naturally, because we are seeing a number of stars on the sky, their light also falls here. So, though we are living upon the earth is surrounded by a number of factors. This is what we call the Panchabhutas. Solid earth, fluid water, gaseous air, different forms of energy represented by fire, light and heat, then surrounded by space. This is called Panchabhutas. So the Panchabhautik world is actually the world around us. Now, all the things which come within this Panchabhautik world, they should become a subject of knowledge for us. Is it not? All the subjects that you have developed, don't think we have developed all the subjects, all the branches of knowledge. Either they deal with matter or they deal with energy. The matter and energy are interconvertible. So they become a subject, a branch of knowledge for us. Now I am asking you, can this alone constitute the university a place of learning? In the universe, all these objects and their ramifications alone, are they alone there? When we say the world around, we see. That seeing process is clearly where? The seeing, does it come to us or does it proceed from us? The seeing is a process. I am seeing the sun. When I see the sun, I become the source of the seeing. Seeing is a process which commences from me. And seeing is a process which concludes in me. In between, the sun becomes an object of perception. Now, to make anything an object of perception, you tell me very clearly by any standard of knowledge you know, does the object being perceived come first or does the subject who is going to perceive it come first? Achhi tarah boliye soch kar. Whenever I see an object, poor object does nothing in the process. I am seeing. So the seeing is proceeding from me. And my seeing says that there is an object. And the color and shape of the object are determined by the seeing, the seer. So the whole universe, however objective and endless and extensive it is, that endlessness, the objectivity, extensiveness, infinitude, all these are predications by the seeing process or the object. Am I clear or not? That there is an object and the object is at a distance and this is what the object means, signifies, etc. All these are purely determined by us. So while the university teaches subjects like physics, chemistry, mathematics, humanities, anthropology, biology, zoology and so many other things, electronics, understand that all these are dealing only with the object. But who gains the knowledge? Who gives rise to the knowing process? Who says that there is the universe? That part is clearly missed by the university. So can it be a university, I am asking you? You have any answer? Am I doing wild thinking or real thinking? A university can never become a university unless the center of the universe, the source of the universe, the source of knowledge, the knowing process, etc. also are taken up. Let us be very clear about it. So my idea of university is a university becomes university only when the whole universe is studied. Not merely the circumference, but the center from which the whole circumference has been made. If you go into geometry, I am told, I understand that any circle is derived from a point. A point is a point. And when you draw a line equidistant from the point, it becomes a circle and a circumference. So the circle is derived from the center. Not only that, a circle is an expanse of the center. Center is a point and the point has no dimension. From the no dimensional point, a huge dimensional circle is born. Is it a fact or not? Yes. Some people will be here who know mathematics and geometry. Yes. From the zero gravity of the earth in the center, the whole huge gravity on the surface has been born. Similarly, the universe also is born from its own center. Anywhere in the world, you tell me, is there any growth from outside to inside? or all forms of growth are from inside to outside. So growth is an expression. Growth is an extension. Growth is an expanse. And this expanse can be only from the center. So the center of the universe is inside the universe, not outside. One more point I want to tell you. Don't make it complicated. Very simple. Does this universe have an object, cause or source? Scientists may take n number of years, but this Swamiji has taken only a short while. This object universe could not have had an object, source or cause. You know why? When I say this is the universe, and here is an object cause from which the universe has sprung, when I say, in as much as the other also is an object, the first reference to the object universe includes that also. Not clear?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
See, when I say the universe, and it has come from that object, my reference to the object means that object also. I am asking you, that object included, what has it come from? You will say another object. That is also included in my object reference. So can the object universe ever have an object cause? क्या सुन रहे हैं क्या? It is so simple as this. You are all born. You have your parents. Parents had their parents. Their parents had their parents. Now let us go to the first parents. Where from were they born? As I say, first parents, before them there were no parents. Because they were the first parents. The first parents could not have been born of another set of parents. If you say another set, that becomes the first. Is it not? So I am speaking about the pre-first parents. Will you not agree that we are all born of something other than human? Similarly, the object world has been born from something other than the object. Now, other than the object, what is there, if at all, in our knowledge? The subject. The subject is there, which is not an object, which is inside the object. If the entire universe is an object, its source is only the subject. It cannot be an object. This I sit in my hermitage and I say this. And the scientists are going to take telescope, microscope, search, research, God particle, interconnection, push. Let them do whatever they like. They will still be experimenting with the object, matter and energy. Whereas we come to the conclusion that it is not. So the matter-energy universe would not have been evolved or emerged from another matter and energy. Because the moment you say another matter or another energy, that is also included in the first reference. So I believe the object universe has always sprung from a subject source. And the moment you say subject source, there is only one place where you can think of it and access it, that is within one's own body. A father cannot access the subject of a child. Can you? Boliyana? What I say, is it relevant or irrelevant? See, you cannot access the mind of your child. You cannot access the buddhi of the child. You cannot access the consciousness of the child. I can only realize, touch, feel, experience the consciousness within myself. The whole body is evolved by nature only to make you sense and comprehend the consciousness that animates it. The purpose of the human body is only this. Otherwise, animal bodies would have been sufficient. All of them are eating. Voluminously they eat. They also live, they also see, they also hear. In order to see, hear and have the delights of the senses, we need not be human beings at all. As human beings, we are only meant to probe into our own body within and unearth the source. What is it that you have from all the multiple interactions with the world and objects? The senses help you to interact. The senses help you to interact. But the senses by themselves cannot interact. The interaction is initiated by a wish or a will in the mind. And the senses become only the media for it. After the senses become media, the experience, the perception is always had within the body, not in the level of the senses. So interactions are initiated by the mind, subsisting on the mind, and concluding and terminating in the mind. Young girls, do you understand what I say? Agree with or not? They are initiated by the mind, subsisting on the mind, and concluded or terminated in the mind, to be carried by the mind as a memory, as a knowledge, to be used by it whenever it wants. Poor senses have nothing to do in it. They are only helping. Now you tell me, what is the source of interaction? Where do the interactions in here, subsist? And where do they conclude? So do you agree it is all a mind process? Now only the human intelligence can understand it. No animal will be able to probe into it and understand. We alone have the faculty of analyzing, understanding, probing, inquiring, investigating, examining, assessing, finding, determining. All these are processes and qualities of the mind, of the intelligence. This is the one important factor that you have to be very clear about. Very clear about. The source of all matter and all energy cannot be matter and energy. The source of object can never be the object. The subject itself is capable of, by virtue of its inscrutable power. What? See, all the other powers you can experiment and find out. How does sodium and chlorine together put together react and finally become sodium chloride? Hydrogen and oxygen combining themselves become H2O, water. These are all objectively experimentable. Very clearly we can understand it. But when it comes to this, you cannot experiment it at all. Nevertheless, you have to know, can mind be experimented? That there is a mind and there is a thought, there is a process inside other than material and energy, it cannot be experimented into at all. In fact, no energy is directly perceptible, if my information is correct. The effect of energy in matter alone is perceptible. Yes or no? What is this? Even in the matter energy realm, energy is not directly perceptible. Suppose there were no dust here, no material particles, I don't think this bulb will be luminous at all. Suppose you go a long distance towards the sun, maybe after you transcend the air, etc., perhaps there will be no light at all, because there is no medium to reflect it. So let us be very clear about it, very clear about it. The more and more you experiment into this world, experiment into your sensations, this is what we find. So, drishyam pradidam pravilapayansan. A university will not be a university unless it is able to discuss the universe in full. And discussing universe in full means that all the objects are present in space. But the space itself is inferable only when the objects are present. Am I right or no? If no objects are there, there will be no space also. And the objects do not transform. If they do not transform, have periodical transformation, there will be no measure or calculation called time at all. When I was speaking in Mukti Sudhagaram and also Inner Spiritual Splendor, I don't have the paper here. We have gone to the minute level of time. I cannot say offhand now how much it is. It is quite a fraction of a second. The time taken for the light to pass one paramanu, that is the least measure of time we have evolved. And from there we have gone. And at one point of time we found the visible world and the changes in the earth will not be sufficient. So we evolved a new process of calculation. What is that? We said Brahma, one day of his Brahma, one year of his Brahma, that becomes one kalpa. We have gone beyond. Even in calculations, we have got names, words for what? Oh, I should have remembered it and got it from the computer then. See, we have got names for, we have name, Desha, Shata, Sahasra, then Desha Sahasra, and then Lakshaha, then we go beyond, then Koti, thereafter we have Ayuta, and so many words are there. Our calculations have gone further and further and further beyond. All these we have specific words. When we say kalpa, it becomes a large measure of time. All these are evolved from the human brain, you should understand. For us, time is not a linear measure. We have got a cyclic measure. Everything in this universe is repetitive in character. So our time is not linear. The present world has come to be. Maybe there was a time when it was not. When it was not, no time was there. And suddenly I use a word. This word is meaningless. I cannot use suddenly then, because time has not come. And then the universe sprang up. When it sprang up, time, object and space altogether were born. It is not that time came later. It is not that objects came later. It is not that space came later. Either there is time, space and object, or neither, no time, no space and no object. In which manner? In the same manner in which the sleeping mind means non-existent mind, no time at all, suddenly gives rise to a dream, dream creation, where time is there, space is there, object is there. And what is this mind? It is non-matter, non-energy. The non-matter and the non-energy have suddenly given rise to matter, energy, time, space, object, everything. In as much as the mind creates all this, don't you think the mind is pre-space, pre-object and pre-time? So here is a source called the mind, which is nowhere and nothing. And that mind gives rise to all these things suddenly. So we have understood the source of all the three. That is what he says, drishyam pratitam pravilapayansan. This drishya is only a display in your mind. Because it is a display in your mind, the universe may be extensive, it may be gross, it may be solid. It may be brilliant, it may be fiery, it may be hot, it may be melting. All these things are, mind you, they are just floating imprints on your own mind. Once you understand this, you can say all the imprints belonging to the mind, caused by the mind, they can be dissolved in the very mind. So the entire drishya visible has to be dissolved in the very source from where it is born. In Yoga Vasishtha there is a verse which says, Chittam Karanam Arthanam. Chittam, the mind. Karanam, the cause. Arthanam, of all objects. Tasmin Sadi Jagatrayam. When the mind is present, the entire world, all the three worlds are present. What are the three worlds? Bhu, bhuvaha, soha. That is what all people will say. That is the Puranic expression for fools. The three worlds are the wakeful world, the sleep world, and the dream world. We don't know of any other world.